In this tutorial, I'll show you what normal maps are and how you can use them to add a lot of detail to your meshes. So let's say we have a surface made of triangles and we want to add more detail to it. A good way to increase the amount of detail it has would be to add more normals so the light can better interact with the surface. But we can only have normals where we have our vertices. So to add more normals, we would have to increase the amount of triangles present, which could hit our performance pretty hard. This is where the beauty of normal maps comes in. We can keep the original count of triangles and instead just wrap a normal map onto the surface. Now every pixel on this normal map will represent one normal for the surface. So we just improve the look of the model a lot while barely hitting the performance of our program. Now let's take a better look at a normal map. As you can see, they are usually very similar to the diffuse map, except they are sort of violet. That is because each pixel of a normal map represents a vector in 3 dimensions. So in other words, the RGB of each pixel stands for the XYZ coordinates. The Z axis, aka blue value, comes out of the surface, and since normals are usually perpendicular to the surface they are on, the normal map is dominated by this violet color. So if something is more reddish, then the normal is pointing to the right, while if it is more greenish, it is pointing up. One last thing to note is that RGB is in the range 0, 1, but we want our normals in the range minus 1, 1, so they can also point in the negative X, Y, and Z axis. So you just need to apply a small transformation when retrieving them. Let's now code it in. You want to start off with a plane that faces the positive Z axis. Now we'll slightly modify our texture class to accept normal maps. The thing about normal maps and basically any sort of texture besides diffuse textures is that we don't want gamma correction on them. So we need to load normal maps as RGB, not sRGB. Don't forget to also load in the texture and send it off to the fragment shader. Now all that's left to do is to read the normals off the normal map, transform them to the negative 1, 1 range, and we're done. You should now have a normal map on your plane. This is nice, but you'll notice that if I move the plane from its position, the normal map will be suddenly wrong. That's because the normal map always points towards the positive Z direction, while in this case, our plane is flat on the ground and pointing in the positive Y direction. This discrepancy causes the error we see. We want the normal map and lighting variables to be in the same space. To do that, we need a so-called TBN matrix, which is made out of the tangent, bitangent, and normal of the surface. To get this, we can use this formula. If you're interested in its derivation, I left some links in the description to some articles on it. Now, since we need all three vertices of a triangle for the formula, you can either calculate the TBN matrix on the CPU or in the geometry shader. I will do it in the geometry shader. So in the default geometry shader that changes nothing, we want to start off by calculating the two edges and two delta texture coordinate values from the formula. Then we calculate the division float and finally the tangent and bitangent. Now we want to import the model matrix into the geometry shader so we can multiply the tangent and bitangent. As for the normal, we want it to be perpendicular to the triangle, but usually not all vertex normals are like that. So instead of getting it from the vertex, we'll calculate it as the cross product between the edges we have. Keep in mind, the order of the edges matters in the cross product. And now we can put all of them together and we have our TBN matrix. We now have two options. We either get the normal map to the same space as the other lighting variables, or we get the other lighting variables to the same space as the normal map. The first option sounds nicer in theory, but it is actually worse, since we can only do that in the fragment shader, while we can do the second option in the geometry shader. Since the fragment shader runs many more times than the geometry shader, it is preferable to take the second option. To do that, we first need to inverse the TBN matrix, but inversing matrices is pretty expensive. Thankfully, this matrix is an orthogonal matrix, which is a fancy way of saying that its inverse is equal to its transpose. So to get the inverse, we can just do the transpose, which is much faster. If I sound like I'm talking gibberish to you, watch 3Blue1Brown series on linear algebra. The final step is to move all the lighting uniforms to the vertex shader, export them, apply the TBN matrix to them in the geometry shader, and then send them off to the fragment shader. Now, no matter the orientation of your triangles, the normal map should still look proper. Don't forget to check out my Discord channel and maybe support me on Patreon. As always, the source code and all sources and resources used are in the description. Bye!